Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. So we will continue our module 3 session. We are in A255. So there is a problem, design. So there is a problem design. You can see here A255 configuration is shown in the figure. So you can see here its configuration is shown. So here port A is configured as input, port B is configured as output, port C lower is configured as output, port C upper is configured as a output. Address is this one. You have to use the address is this one. That means in the design it says like you have to configure the port A as input, port B as output, port C lower as output, port C upper as output, and address is this one. What is this address? First decide the address. So first here A0, A1. A0, A1, let us take A0, A1, 1, 1. So let me write here. Let me write here A0, A1. This is the combination A0, A1. A0, A1. After that, A2 is equal to 0. A3 is equal to 0. A4 is equal to 1. A5 is equal to 0. A6 is equal to 0. A7 is also 0, A8 is equal to 1, A9 is equal to 1. So now from here we will divide this one. So now this is 3, this is 1, and this is 0. And in the previous table you have seen A0, A1. Combination A0 and 0 and 1, A1 combination 00 port A and 01 port B, 10 port C. So 311, this is port A, this is port B, 311 port B. Next one is 312 port C, and last one is 313 is for a control register. See, you refer the table. I have in the previous video while explaining programmable peripheral interface, one table is there. In the table, chip select A0 A1 is given. Based on that, based on this last four combinations, based on this last two bits. For this one is A, B, C, D decided. You can see here, let me take you to this one. See, same thing is written here. So based on A1 and A0, rest of the things same here. Port A, port B, port C and control register. Now control register value, port A should be input port. So port A should be input port. So D7 bit is 1, control register, D7 bit in control register, control register, let me write here, D7 bit is equal to 1, that is input output mode, and other two bits are 0. Then D6 and D5, D4 is port, D4 port A, so port A indicates 1. Then D7, D6, D5, D4, D3 is a port C upper, that is 0, 0 because output port, and D2 is also 0, D1 is also 0, port B and port C lower is also 0, that means it's 90. So 90 is first moved to AL, and from there it is moved to 313. you have to do this one, otherwise your ports are not configured. Once this is done, ports are configured. Now whatever the value, now take the address of the port, first for this one input port, in get the data, address of the output port, move the data. So send the data, so once again get the address of the C port, and move the data. So this is the small program actually. Get the data and move the data. You have to get the data here and we have to move the data here. So by seeing this diagram, you have to first decide what is the port address. Then but by seeing this one, you have to decide what is the control register. Then first you have to move the control register value through port number 313. That time all the ports are get configured. Now get the data through port A, move it through port B, get the data through port A, move it through port C. That's all. We'll see one more program here. Here also you can see all the ports are configured here, output port. So the address of the decoding circuit is shown here. It says address of the decoding circuit is shown in the diagram. Control word for all ports as output. Since all the port is output port, it is ATH. The program below will toggle. What is this program? This will toggle all bits of port A indefinitely with the delay in between. All the bits of the port A will toggle. All the bits of port A will toggle indefinitely with the delay in between. For toggling, I have to use this keyword. Here you can see for toggling, I have to use this keyword. You see this keyword and one is this keyword, other one is this keyword. So one is this keyword, other one is this keyword. So let us see first keyword. First keyword is zero. Let us see first keyword. First keyword is 0101. This is 55H. Other keyword is A 1010. This is A. And once again 1010A. This is A. So now two data we are taking 55 and AA to toggle the bits of the port A. So what is the address here? Let us see the first address. Address is equal to, according to this one, A0A1 is control bits. A0 and A1 is control bits. We will take that later. Then other than that, 0000, 006 zeros and 11. That is 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros and this one combination. So here, let us divide into blocks of this one. A0, A1, A2, A3, this is the one block, A4, A5, A6, A7, this is the other block. Now here it is 3, 0, first combination becomes 0, A0, A1 combination 0, 0 means 0, second combination is 0, 0, 1 comes automatically, third combination 0, 0, 2 comes, fourth combination 0, 0, 3, 3 0, 0, 3 is used for a control register. So you can see here control register address 003, that you have to move to DX, then move the value 880. What you got, this one for control, this one control register port configuration 80, that value you move to AL. then send it to output port, so that control register, once you send this value through the control register value through output port, all the ports are configured. Now get the port A address, get the data 55, send it to output port, call delay, then get the data once again AA, send it to output port, call delay, and see whether any key is pressed. To check the whether any key is pressed, we are using interrupt 16H. Interrupt 16H is with the H1. If the key is pressed, this will not result in 0. The value in AL is different. If the key is not pressed, the value in AL is 0, and this will repeat indefinitely. As soon as the key is pressed, this will come out with this interrupt. Now, delay program, very, very important. They may ask this delay program separately, how this delay program works. Delay program, actually, they will ask you to generate the delay program. So you have to remember there is a port 61, port address 61. The main job of the port address, port 61, is to generate delay. So what this port 61 will do? Port 61 has got 8 bits. So the port 61 has got 8 bits. That is 1 1 1 1 1 4 5 6 7 8. In that D4 bit of this port 61, every 15 microsecond, let me check 1 minute. Yeah, every 15.085 microsecond, D4 bit of the port 61 toggle from 1 to 0. 0 to 1, that concept we are using to generate a delay every 15 microsecond. Now here, suppose I want delay to generate 1 by 4 second. To generate 1 by 4 second, I have to multiply with certain count to that 15 microsecond. This is microsecond. When I multiply this 15 microsecond with the 16,572, then I will get a delay of 1 by 4. Similarly, they may ask you to generate a delay of 1 by 2. So you have to see this count value. You have to calculate, you have to remember this count value, or from the exam point of view, for 1 by 2 delay. After that, you have to move that count in CX register. Now, input from 61 port. Now that content is, you check whether the content is something like this. And compare this one with the AH. Initially, whatever the value of AH, let it be. Jump equal, it will repeat these many count times. Otherwise, it will exchange the value and it will go on loop. So first time, as soon as it scans the input port 61, the value may be different. That is 00000. That will compare with the AH value. So let me explain you this one. Initially you take the value, this one, when it scans the input port, this is the value, and your value in AH register is something different. Take some junk value in AH register, 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, something junk value. Initially what it will do, it will compare. If it is not equal, it will move this value to this value, and once again it will check the input port. Now in AH register, we have what value? We have 00010000 is there. Now it will repeat. Once again it will check. That time AL value is something, once again the AL value comes from input port is something this one. And it will compare. Both are equal. It will repeat till this value changes. Once this value changes, this will come out. This will come out. That will generate delay of one divided by 4 second. So this will repeat total many times, 16,572 times to generate 1/4 second delay. The bit will change every 15 microsecond. So this loop will repeat this many times. So no need to get confused. This is somewhat complicated. So this delay is called in the program. So every alternative, this one, 1/4 second, the bits of this program, that is output port that is connected to either LED or whatever may be, it will toggle with the AL value 55 and AL value AA. So this is very one important program from the exam point of view. Now buffering 3031F address range. So we have seen this one, only one question is there here. Bus extender. So draw the diagram of a bus extender, ISA bus extender. Draw the diagram of ISA bus extender or design of 8-bit ISA PC bus extender. You can see here. So this is the bus. This is 8086 bus, data bus and address bus. So as the signals drives so many chips, bus signal will get, this signal will get weakened. So weaken. So in order to amplify the signal, we are using amplifier here, 74LS245U, either buffer or latch. This will amplify the signal. This is called as bus extender. Bus extender, ISA 8-bit bus extender, you can see. So for data bus, we are using one chip. For address bus, we are using one chip. So here it is shown only this much. So if the data bus is 16-bit chips are used, or two chips are used, address bus also two chips are used, control bus also we will use one more chip. So this is called as bus extender. Bus extender. Now write a program to toggle all bits of PA and PB with the 1/2 second delay. So the program is same, 1/2 second delay. What is the count you have to remember? I have explained this program just now to turn off and turn on the bits of port A. In between it will call delay. So to generate the delay of 1/2 second, what is the count? You have to remember 33,000 to generate 1/4 second. It was 16,000 odd. It is 33,000 odd. And that count you have to load in CX register. And you have to input 61, port number 61, whose D4 bit will toggle every 15 microsecond. So that concept is used to generate this delay. This is one more program for delay generation. This one to toggle the bits with the delay of 1/2, and the previous program was toggle the bits with the delay of 1/4. So with this, we have completed module 3. So in the next session, we will move to ARM module 4 of microprocessor and microcontroller. Thank you.